Charlie McAvoy. It's official. Boston has locked up their stud blue liner to an 8-year contract extension with an AAV of 9.5 milli. So Charlie Mack gets paid.
Was texting with him recently and moments before the show. Congrats, Mack, to you, as I said on text. More importantly, one of the best D in the league.
Yep.
I love his emergence. He can play in all situations, dependable, very infectious personality. His teammates love him. Gamer in all situations.
Confident.
Super confident. Great swag. But here's the one thing. This kind of resets the bar, the salary bar down in Boston.
Ooh. Yes.
Huh? I saw your projection, and you're usually bang on.
I was wrong on this
and
one.
And this exceeded it.
Well, see, and I've been pretty good on them.
You've been very good on them.
Was
Johnny was 8.3, right?
I said 8.9.
8.9.
Okay.
Okay, yeah. That's
his number in there. But I was, and listen, I think what people need to realize, he might not put up as many points as Victor Hedman or Campbell Carr, or he hasn't yet. But that doesn't mean he's not as good of a defenseman.
Exactly.
He's absolutely a top five defenseman in the world right now.
Is there a Norris in his future?
He's going to have to score more points. He's going to win it because voters are drawn to points. But
what? That's a whole skill-wise,
skill-wise, yes.
Okay.
I was curious, though, was would he be handcuffed by Cale Makar, who I think is probably the best young defense in the league, who makes $9 million a year, and say, okay, well, you're not quite him. We'll get you under him. Or will you get drawn up to Nurse?
Yeah.
Werenski and Jones, who he's better than all those guys who all make around 9.5. And clearly, he was drawn up to those guys. He'd taken his bridge deal. It wasn't coming out of entry level. So his contract situation was more similar to them.
Mm-hmm. Yep.
And so he got the 9.5 and not under 9, which I thought the Makar and the Boston Bruins kind of
home discount
salary structure on their team, even if he's going to be the highest, not to go that much more over Bergeron and Marchand and Pasta and everybody else. But congratulations. Totally deserves it. I think he
100%.
Like, how can an American-born player who plays on one of the biggest franchises in the league, who's an absolute star, charismatic, all of it, somehow be underrated?
Underappreciated.
Underrated.
Yes.
He is.
Yeah.
Maybe this contract, we should clue people in. He was worth every cent. He's one of the best defensemen in the league.
Yeah.
Maybe let's tell the people at home why. Because people outside of Boston, to your point, may be new to Charlie McAvoy. Maybe only see him when they play the Boston Bruins, which if you're looking at last year, they all played within their division. Yeah. So what is it that makes him so dynamic?
Everything. Watching him when he played at school at BU, I thought he was money. World Junior Team USA, gold. He was absolutely money. Came up to Providence at the end of the year when he signed. Mm-hmm. Was unreal. And then came up to the National Hockey League for the playoffs and was sick there too. Plays big minutes, agile, outstanding hockey IQ, can make amazing reads, defends hard, he's physical, and he's charismatic.
That's it. I think that's what separates him from the other guys. He's a puck facilitator, so he doesn't rush it himself, but he passes it brilliantly, defends blue line really well, and is the best defender of all those top-end guys. Mm-hmm. He's better than Jones. He's better defensively. That's what separates him, makes him a great two-way defender, is how good he is while trying to stop the other guys from scoring, not just trying to score himself.
All right, well, congratulations again to Charlie Mack, getting his moolah, as they say.